I asked you last class about the COOH, if it be counted in tertiary.
Yes.
And I asked my teacher. She said, she told me that if in case, like that will not be counted as the third carbon. Like if there's a structure which has, say, one hydrogen, one and two other methyl, and there is a COOH, then that carbon will be counted as secondary carbon and not tertiary, because the COOH is a
functional group.
Yeah.
Yeah. Makes sense. Cool. Arnav, okay, but I'm glad you joined. We're literally just starting. It's good. Okay. So we were starting about preparation methods. So preparation, you have like three major ways of preparing haloalkanes, haloarenes. So the first method of preparation, like, would be from alcohols. Then you have from pure hydrocarbons. And then we have one more method, substitution reactions, like from other haloalkanes itself. Like if you have chloromethane, how do you convert it into bromomethane? Something like that. Yeah, so we'll start off with alcohols. There are three, four reagents you can use to prepare haloalkanes from alcohols. So alcohols, if you remember, OH group hai. First method is a very direct substitution reaction. You take an alcohol, make it react with a halo acid. Halo acid is pretty straightforward. The acids that contain halogens. So halo acids, general form is HX. So we're talking about HCl, HBr, HI, whatever you want, depending on what haloalkane you want. So the halogen will substitute the alcoholic group, and that's how you get the haloalkane, you get water. Okay. So this particular reaction, it has a name, Groves reaction. This is the general form of reaction. If you want to prepare primary or secondary alcohols, you need zinc chloride to kickstart the reaction. Okay. The reason is that when it comes to primary and secondary alcohols, if you compare primary alcohols, secondary alcohols with tertiary alcohols, out of these three, which one forms the most stable carbocation?
Tertiary.
Tertiary forms the most stable carbocation, right? Abhi, if we want to kick OH out and include the halogen over here, the kind of mechanism this follows is, you need to be able to prepare this carbocation over here. With tertiary, it happens automatically because tertiary carbocations is most stable. It doesn't mind forming the carbocation quite easily. But with primary and secondary, because it's not as stable, you need to give it a little bit of push, which is why you use zinc chloride. Yeah. So zinc chloride acts as Lewis acid, helps in breaking the CO bond. CO bond is basically the bond between the carbon of the alkyl group and oxygen of the alcohol group. So in order to be able to break this bond, you kind of need a catalyst there, which is what is the purpose of zinc chloride. You don't need that in tertiary because tertiary carbocations are most stable. So breaking this bond is quite easy. Oxygen will take its electrons and this forms a tertiary carbocation and it happens. And because it is easy to form the tertiary carbocation, you can see that those alcohols are more reactive compared to primary and secondary in this reaction. And if you just simply shake the test tube with the halo acid at room temperature, you'll get your haloalkane. Okay. So these are like some of the important points related to this particular equation. Once you guys are done with this, we'll do a couple of example reactions for this.
Ma'am?
Yeah?
The addition will follow like the normal like Markovnikov addition, right?
Is this an addition reaction?
No, like, I mean, like, the X would go to, like, the C that the tertiary and the H would go to, like, the other one.
What are you talking about, Ritu? See what is happening in the reaction, no? ROH, that's turning into RX. So only the functional group, like OH, is being substituted with the halogen over here. Yeah, so this is not addition. This is a substitution reaction. Addition is when R remains as it is, and then extra, like 1H, 1X, that sort of thing is getting added.
Oh, ma'am, the ZnCl, is it like part of the reaction or is it like a catalyst to like break the bond?
Catalyst, the agent, you put it over the arrow.
That's right. Okay.
So zinc chloride acts, so I'll tell you what happens, what is the purpose of zinc chloride. The mechanism is basically like this. So, sabse pehle, ZnCl2 is a Lewis acid. Do you guys remember what are Lewis acids, Lewis bases? Lewis acids kya hai? Property kya, what makes them Lewis acids?
Lewis acids can take electrons and then Lewis bases donate electrons.
Correct. So Lewis acids are electron acceptors. They're deficient in electrons. They want to take electrons. So what happens is ZnCl2 breaks, like it approaches HX. Like consider, let's say this is HCl. So this basically forms a complex with this ZnCl3 minus, think of it like that, plus H plus. Now the proton that is generated, this attacks the alcohol. Alcohol mein kya hai? ROH. Oxygen has lone pair of electrons. So positive proton gets attracted to negative electrons. So what happens is, you have RO, H is already there. This gets attached to, like once the H plus acts, positive charge on oxygen. Now oxygen cannot take a positive charge. It's very, very electronegative. So what it does is it pulls on this pair of electrons. This whole part gets removed as water. That is the byproduct here. And you get a carbocation. And yeah, so this carbocation is attracted to the negative charge on Cl minus. So basically, you end up with a haloalkane and ZnCl2, like this complex breaks down, right? So you get that ZnCl2 back. Okay. So whole of organic chemistry, remember one thing, it gets really, really easy. You just need to follow and figure out and follow where electrons go. Electrons are negatively charged. They're always attracted with positive charge. So you just need to figure out which is electron deficient, which is electron rich, and then make those connections. Now, this is for primary and secondary. Tertiary alcohols ke liye, you don't need this H plus special, like this particular, this formation is quite easy. So this bond is very, very, like it'll break quite easily compared to primary and secondary. So you don't need the zinc chloride. HX, HCl has a property of splitting as H plus and Cl minus. So, you know, the H plus will approach it. It'll directly like break easily and it'll happen spontaneously. Yeah. So note down a couple of example reactions. All of you done noting like these 3 points, right? General reaction in these points. Okay. Now, we'll start off simple plus HBr in the presence of zinc chloride. What would be the products? Predict the products escape. So this is one. Yes. This is one way you'll be asked. Again, remember what I said about organic chemistry in grade 11. Your questions ka pattern will be the same. Either you'll be asked to figure out the reactant, or you'll be asked to predict the product, or you'll be asked to figure out what the agent is required in order to convert it. Nice. Quite straightforward. Smera, Arya, Sia, Ritu. Sanskriti, Adit, Kaveri, Arnav. Adit Sen. Yes. Kaveri and Arnav, you guys sending? Arnav, I don't have your video on also, are you here? Yes, Kaveri got it. Sounds creepy, yes. Arnav Shah, where are you at? Okay. In the meantime, okay, do the second one. So I have methanol. On treating with reagent A, gives me chloromethane plus water. Identify A.
Ma'am, what about ZnCl2?
So that's what your answer needs to be complete. Ritu, it's not just zinc chloride. No, if I treat methanol with zinc chloride, I'm not gonna get chloromethane, right? What should I use in order to convert this to this?
HCl.
Yes. Smera, absolutely. That's how you put the answer. Yeah. Sia, yes.
I didn't get it. Is A HCl or ZnCl2?
See, if you look at this, you need both, right? So the answer to this, the way you answer this is A is HCl plus ZnCl2. Now, if I have this compound, CH3 taken thrice COH, the agent B gives CH3 taken thrice CCl plus H2O. What would B be? Yes, Ritu has got the hang of it. Sia and Arya, pay attention. Reactant yahan pe humne kya liya? Kaveri, like Smera also got the hang of it. Sia, Arya, Kaveri, pay attention to the reactant here. What type of a compound is it? Haha, Sia now corrected it. Correct. Sanskriti, Adit, Arnav, I've not received. Yes, Arya also corrected it now. Kaveri, yes. So those are like the key nuances that you need to pay attention. You know, these kind of questions. That's the reason we give all these facts. So you won't be asked direct questions about it. You'll need to apply it by making this way. Arnav, I got the answer to the first one now. Kya hua? Where were you?
Plus, I don't know, like, I'm getting out of the meeting and again in the meeting. So it's a bit disturbing for me.
Okay.
I didn't get it. Like, I know ZNCL too. You take plus. Like, do we have to take?
See, what do we have here? This is a general reaction. If it is primary or secondary, tabhi ZNCL2 chahiye. If it is tertiary, we just need to take simply HX. We don't need ZNCL2 in that case. So look at the reactant here. In this case, mare pass like methyl hai na, it's like a primary or it's not exactly primary, but like methyl hai. This is not going to form a carbocation easily. So in order for this reaction to happen, ye OH ko Cl mein convert karne ke liye, we need both HCl and ZNCl2. Okay. Now, if you look at this reaction, this is a tertiary carbon, a tertiary alcohol. C is connected to three of the methyl groups, which is connected to OH. Right? So, tertiary case mein kya ho raha hai?
You take HX then as B.
Yes, correct. HX, kyunki hamara product Cl hai, so we specifically take B will be HCl.
Oh, okay.
यहाँ पे जो भी हैलोजन ले रहे हो, that is getting substituted here. RHCl. So अगर क्लोरीन चाहिए तो HCl, ब्रोमीन चाहिए तो HBr, आयोडीन चाहिए तो HI. That way.
We got it.
Yes. Cool. So this is a direct substitution. From alcohols, you can use halo acids. This is one reagent. Then, next, specifically, if you want to prepare bromoalkanes, HBr, think of it as a different case from this. This is like any halogen, HX, HBr, HI with ZnCl2. This is another reagent you can take. You can take HBr in the presence of concentrated H2SO4. This also gives you bromoalkane plus water. So this, in the presence of concentrated H2SO4, doesn't work with HCl, because again, the acidic nature, the pKa values of HCl, it won't work the way you want it to. Like, this particular substitution will not happen. Because of acidic conditions, it, like, you know, dehydrating nature will overtake it, and you know, this particular mechanism will not follow. But in the case of HBr and HI, like even for iodine, boiling it in the presence of sulfuric acid will work.
I didn't catch that. Could you try again?
Sorry. So constant boiling of alcohols with 48% HBr and presence of sulfuric acid. So once you finish noting down, let me know. Then we'll discuss both of these. What is the difference between both and what's happening in this case?
Oh, ma'am, in the second, generate HBr in situation, right? It's a
question. Yeah, finish noting down, then I'll discuss it. Siya's done, Ritu's done, Smira's done. Cool. Adit's done. Okay. Are you also completed? Yeah. Kaveri, completed or noting down? No. All right. So the first method, direct method, self-explanatory, you directly take HPR, you boil it, and then you'll get it. Same reaction as before, where OH is getting substituted by the halogen, because you need the haloalkane. Okay. Now, second method, this is something that you'll come across a fair few times, not just in this case, but even in other chapters and other things also. In situ, yeah, as Adit said, it's basically the meaning you can take it as in situation, you know, in the test tube itself. Instead of preparing HBr prior, what you're doing is you're preparing H plus and Br minus within the test tube itself so that they'll go ahead and react it. Okay. So where are you getting the HBr from is by taking a bromide salt. So that's either NaBr or KBr. Boil it with concentrated H2SO4. Again, if you remember equilibrium chapter, the combination of both of these basically establishes that equilibrium. So NaBr and KBr, salts kaise bante hain? If you boil like NaOH with the HBr, neutralization reaction say you get it, right? So imagine uska reverse reaction is taking place. Let me write it down, make it clear. If I take NaBr, so if I neutralize NaOH and HBr, acid-base reaction, neutralize hone pe, you get NaBr and H2O. So think of it as iska hi reverse reaction. So I have H plus ions from concentrated H2SO4, Br minus from these salts. So the combination of both of those will basically create the HBr in situ, like in that test tube or in that beaker where you're doing the reaction. Okay. So the result is the same. You still get RBr and H2O, but because you're taking a combination of this, you also get this as a side product. So essentially what is happening in this case is, so NaBr turns into Na plus and Br minus. H2SO4, say you're getting H plus ions and HSO4 minus ions. The HBr will take part in the substitution of the alcohol, and remaining Na plus and HSO4 minus ions you have within the solution will form the salt. Make sense, clear? Like if you come across these reactions, will you be able to predict the product? Baad mein? Everyone? Sia, Smira, Arna, Kaveri?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Sanskriti? Making sense?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, ma'am.
So similarly, we also have the case for iodides, for iodoalkanes, like when you want to substitute with iodine, same thing, heat alcohol with constant boiling 57% HI. In this case, you don't need H2SO4. If you want to generate HI in situ, just like with bromide we saw earlier, abhi HI ke liye I, you get it from the salt. H plus B hona chahiye na. Where do you get it from? You use phosphoric acid. So if you observe, all of them follow the same pattern. Like roughly, if you look at the reactions, it's alcohol mein OH group is substituted by the halogen group, be it Cl, Br, iodine, jo bhi ho. But multiple ways of achieving that, either like in all cases, you're using halo acids only, like HCl, HBr, HI. using either you can use a Lewis acid like ZnCl2, or you can use a regular acid like H2SO4 and H3PO4. That way. So observe the pattern, it'll get easier. Like you won't have to remember, like you don't have to like memorize these things. Patterns say, you know, you'll be able to figure out, you can predict the reactions much more easily. So these are like the basic reactions. Then we'll talk about other points related to this. Sia, Smera, Arnav, Kaveri, let me know when you guys are done. I can't see you guys, so I don't know if you're following the work. Okay. Okay, so order of reactivity, as expected, tertiary will be the most reactive because it can form that carbocation quite easily, followed by secondary, followed by primary. For any specific alcohol, if you want to compare iodide versus bromide versus chloride, iodides are the most reactive, followed by bromide, followed by chloride. Can anyone figure out why this trend? Like, what is the reason behind this car reactivity?
Iodine is less electronegative than chlorine. Therefore, it has a weaker bond with the hydrogen and is easier to break.
You're talking about hydrogen. We have hydrogen in all three cases. Why is it
iodine and hydrogen bond? Because iodine is less electronegative.
Yes, there you go. You can also talk about it in terms of size. So if you compare HI, hydrogen hai, iodine is large. HBr, hydrogen is there, slightly smaller than this thing. And if you take HCl, same hydrogen, even smaller than bromine. Abhi tino mein nucleus hai. In which case do you think is this particular bond the strongest?
It's HCl.
HCl, right? So if bond strongest in this case, matlab, which is the most easiest to break? In this case, it is the weakest. Can you break a strong bond easily or can you break a weak bond easily?
Weak bond.
Yeah, so this is the easiest to break. So if you can break it easily, that will contribute to the reactivity. Because you need that I minus to react. So jitna jaldi I minus create hoga, jitna easily I minus create hoga, utna easily reaction ho jayega. So size ki wajah se, that obviously indirectly affects the electronegativity as well. Yeah, can mention both. This is a thing I mentioned when we were discussing bromoalkanes. So secondary tertiary bromides iodides cannot be prepared in the presence of sulfuric acid as the alcohol would undergo dehydration to form alkenes. This would be the preferred mechanism compared to substitution. So the second and third reactions that we did, that's suitable only for primary haloalkanes. You can just make a note of that. In fact, note it down beside the reaction itself. So where you have put the generalized reaction. Either you can put it in brackets, only primary haloalkanes. Now, maybe only primary haloalkanes. So this is all, like, if you're taking an alcohol, haloacids, the most direct reagent that you can use. The next set, you can also, again, haloalkanes, matlab, we're looking at sources of halogens, right? So phosphorus halides, so PCl3, PCl5. You can also use PBr3, PI3, PBr5, PI5. Basically, phosphorus halides. So make alcohols react. So if it is, again, these are like the generalized reactions, guys. If you're using PCl5, one chlorine gets substituted, like one chlorine substitutes the OH to form your chloroalkane, haloalkane. Byproducts are HCl and POCl3. In the case of trichlorides, PCl3, it is a very direct substitution. Each chloro will substitute each OH from the alcohol, and each of these OH comes, joins, attaches with the phosphorus here. That's why you're getting H3PO3 as the byproduct. So essentially, you can think of this as POH thrice. But again, because this is a non-metal, if you look at the structure of it, it basically behaves as an acid. So you write it as H3PO3. Basically, phosphorus with OH.
Ma'am.
Yeah?
Could you repeat the part about PCl3?
Yeah. So PCl3, the reaction is just like with haloacids. Each chlorine substitutes the OH from each alcohol, which is why each PCl3 reacts with 3 moles of the alcohol molecules. So PCl3 ka structure kya hai? So initially it was PCl and Cl. As each chlorine gets substituted with OH, this is your final byproduct. So it's basically POH thrice, but because it's an acid, because this has acidic characteristics, you write it as H3PO3. So there's a difference between reactions of PCl5 and PCl3 because the byproducts that you get is different in both the cases. In this case, it's like a simple substitution. But in the case of pentachlorides, only one chlorine substitutes the alcoholic group and you end up with POCl3 and HCl as the byproducts. And if you want to prepare bromo or iodo alkanes, this reaction gets slow. You can't directly prepare this. So just like with the haloacids, you prepare them in situ by taking phosphorus and the halogen directly. You take red phosphorus, make it react with either bromine or iodine, Br2 or I2. Within the test tube, this basically forms, which reacts with the alcohol, giving you that particular haloalkane. So in the case of, another reagent, apart from haloacids, what you can use is, one is PCl3, other is PCl5, or you can use red phosphorus with that particular halogen. Bromine and iodine ke liye, this is most effective, but you can also use this with chlorine. You can take red phosphorus in the presence of Cl2 gas also, it will follow the same reaction. So these are the 3 reagents, phosphorus related reagents that you can use that react with alcohols to give you haloalkanes. So we're studying each of these reactions in depth. Once we are done with all the preparation methods, I'll give you guys like a summary of each of these reactions so that if it's in one place, it's easier to just, you know, for quick revision. Again, now because like last year you had only one chapter, now you're going to have multiple chapters and these reactions are also going to be repetitive. Here you're studying preparation of haloalkanes from alcohols. You'll have the same reactions again in alcohols ka chapter as chemical properties of alcohols. What happens if alcohols react with like HCl? Then what happens if alcohols react with like PCl3, PCl5? So I would suggest, like I suggested it last year also, do the same thing this year where have like one notebook or a chart or something where you put all the reactions, make three columns. So the first column will be your reactant or substrate. So this is like, what is reacting? Alcohol, aldehyde, alkane, jo bhi hai. Your substrate, then your reagent. What all are you using? HCl, HCl plus ZnCl2, or H2SO4 only, or hydrolysis, acidic hydrolysis, jo bhi hai. Reagent, and then product. No place to get. So make three columns, substrate, reagent, product. Make a list of the reactions. So in a different chapter, if it is repeated again, like if there's extra points related to alcohols that you come across, you can just like make note of it over here itself. And even when you're like solving questions and all, you'll have this for reference ready. Now, if it's like, okay, alcohol related thing and substrate alcohol, you can just refer to it. Like, think of it as like, prepare like a master list of reactions. If tabular form helps you, if you think, oh, this is quite clear for me to reference, you can do that. Or if you want to prepare like a flowchart of it, preparation, yahan pe haloalkane aaya, and then continue here. Haloalkane with a different reagent gives you alcohol, like whatever makes sense to you, but create like a master list of all the reactions that will help you revise. So are we done with all the phosphorus halide related things? Okay. Next, thionyl chloride. Another fact, guys, whenever you come across the prefix thio, it means it is sulfur related. Okay. It'll help you, like if you forgot about anything, if you haven't heard of a reagent or something, thio means sulfur. So thionyl chloride is SOCl2. Just like how halo is like halogen. Lime, like soda, is sodium related, like baking soda, caustic soda. Lime is like calcium related. That way, thio matlab, you know, there's sulfur involved. So thio esters would be like, instead of oxygen, you have sulfur there. Like that, that's an example. So thionyl chloride is also pretty straightforward. Alcohol, thionyl chloride, in the presence of pyridine. Pyridine is an organic base. Like NaOH, KOH, all of these are inorganic bases, right? Pyridine is an organic base. Iska structure hai, it's like a benzene ring, except one of them, like instead of carbon, you have nitrogen here. 1, 2, 3, this is the structure of pyridine. So if you want to have a basic medium, without having to use NaOH or KOH. Because if you use NaOH, the OH minus is going to, you know, get involved and spoil your reaction. So you don't want to use an OH minus, but you want like base because you want to remove like H plus or something to act as a base. You usually go for pyridine. Another thing, this is an organic base, right? So if there's any solution that ionic compounds are not going to dissolve in, this is a good alternative for organic reactions. Basic nature, nature. Okay, and this is the industrial method of preparation. You can also note that down. And this is used in the industry, preferred method for industrial preparation, because if you look at the byproducts, you're getting sulfur dioxide and HCl, which are both gases. So you don't have to like again invest in fractional distillation or filtration or extra process. You can just get your haloalkane and these two will escape out in the atmosphere. Pretty easy to separate because they're gases. So gaseous byproducts can escape out, giving like purification gets easier compared to the other methods.
Miss, what did you say about pyridine being an organic base?
Oh, pyridine is a compound. It's an organic base. It's a basic compound like your NaOH, KOH. Usually you'll come across this in reactions that require basic medium. Like agar basic medium chahiye to remove acid or to neutralize acids or something like that. And you don't want OH minus ions in the solution. Or if it's a case where like all of these are organic compounds, covalent compounds, you can't dissolve NaOH, KOH to do their job, then you use pyridine. It's an organic compound that has basic nature. So that works well in some reactions. You'll come across this in other reactions also, like these kind of cases where you need a base. Okay. So once you're done noting, I'll just give a summary of all the reactions. Another point about this. So thionyl chlorides ke liye, you can only prepare haloalkanes. So you cannot prepare haloarenes. In fact, it's not just for thionyl chloride. Like alcohol ka, like if you're using alcohol, this goes in general for all alcohol related preparation methods. You cannot prepare haloarenes using phenol. Phenol, if you guys remember, it's basically benzene ring with OH. Yeah. Can anyone figure out the reason why? Think? I'll give you guys 2 minutes. Let's see if you can figure out. If not, I'll tell you what the answer is. Okay, Ritu has sent, Ritu is saying, is it because it wouldn't be as reactive as primary, secondary, tertiary carbon and or would pair up with hydrogen instead of X? No. Yeah,
I'm sorry. Reactive,
isliye reaction nahi hoga. But why? Arya has sent, yeah, Adit, what were you saying?
I have a question, I just had to go for 2 minutes.
Oh. So I'm saying like you can't prepare haloarenes using all of these methods of, you know, like using phenol, just like how we used other alcohols.
Okay.
This is why. Arya said because the CO bond is strong. I'm assuming you mean CO bond in phenol specifically compared to regular alkanes.
Yeah.
Yes, you are correct. But why is it strong? Why is it stronger than the other alcohols?
benzene rings have resonance, so because of resonance.
Yeah, because of resonance.
Correct. Absolutely. So in the case of phenol, the lone pair of electrons on oxygen are there. That gets involved in the resonance structure, which makes it difficult to break this like carbon-oxygen bond. And the whole point of all the reactions we saw is that pura OH is getting substituted by the halogen. So that is why we can't prepare haloarenes using phenol due to resonance. The CO bond has partial double bond characteristics. And it's difficult to break. Okay, even it noted down in bullet points, three simple points. One is the lone pair of electrons and oxygen involved in resonance. Resonance means partial double bond characteristics. Double bond means stronger to break, difficult to break. Guys, let me know if you hear like any background noise, okay? Because the fan is making sound. If that's interfering, I'll shut it off. Otherwise, it's fine.
It's fine.
The only time we hear background noise is like when your Siri starts talking, saying they don't understand the chem you were asking about.
Sorry, can you repeat that? What happened?
The only time there's like background noise is like when your Siri says that they can't understand the chem that you're talking about.
Yeah. That, I don't know how it gets activated. It just randomly gets activated. Smera, Sia, Sanskriti, Arnav, let me know when you guys are done noting.
Yes, one second.
These are the main points. Note about pyridine so you know what it is. This is the preferred method. And this is not specific to thionyl chlorides. This is applicable to, like, you can't use phenol. Like other aliphatic alcohols you can use. But phenol, you can't use any of the reactions. Adia done. Sanskriti finished?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Cool. I'll just summarize all the alcohol related reactions. So first, ROH alcohols, haloacids, HCl. This is in the presence of zinc chloride and hydrozinc chloride, of course. Zinc chloride you use only for primary and secondary. You get RCl plus H2O. Next, ROH, in situ methods, NABR. So when I'm using NABR, how do I produce HBr in situ? Like, what else should I take for this?
Sulfuric acid.
H2SO4 gives RBr plus NaHSO4 plus H2O. Next, phosphorus related, if I take 3ROH plus PX3 gives, what would be the products for this reaction? Sia?
3RX, POX3 and H3PO4.
Why do you get POX3? I'm just taking trichlorides only, phosphorus trihalide.
Oh.
Teen use kiya na, simple substitution. Hai. So other thing is H3PO3. Okay. Alternate for this, you can also use either PX3 or
PCl5.
Huh. PCl5, your byproducts will change. So red P or X2, where X can be either chlorine or bromine or iodine. The other thing specific only for chlorine is single again ROH plus PCl5. In this case, okay, what are the products? How many haloalkanes, alkyl halides will I get? And what else will I get? Sanskriti? Products for this? You can flip back, study, and let me know. This is not a test. This is the first time you're studying, so it's okay.
RCl, POCl3, and HCl.
RCl plus POCl3 plus HCl. Cool. And finally, we have thionyl chloride. ROH plus SOCl2 gives RCl, of course. What are the byproducts for thionyl chloride, Arnav?
Yes, ma'am. So it will be SCl plus H2O.
Close, Nick. Just reorder them. SCl, there is no product, no. Sulfur ka valency 2 hai. Or chlorine is only 1. So you can't have SCl. Minimum 2 hona chahiye sulfur ke liye. It goes 2, 4, 6. So, sulfur dioxide and HCl. Also remember, like iske byproducts are all gases, right? So what gases do you know of sulfur? Sulfur dioxide is a gas. It's a pollutant. SO2, SO3. यहाँ पे दो ऑक्सीजन है सो SO2 विल बी अ बाय प्रोडक्ट एंड रिमेनिंग एक क्लोरीन तो यहाँ पे सब्स्टिट्यूट हो गया सो HNCl विल फॉर्म HCl.
ओके मैम.
यस Yeah. So these are all the reactions related to alcohols. These are the reagents you can use. Haloacids prepared in C2, NaBr, H2O, Na(I), and H3PO4. Then you get Ri. Then you have phosphorus related, either you can directly take it or you can prepare it in C2. And you have PCl5 and you have thionyl chloride. Okay. Quick summary. Final points, you've noted it down. The kind of questions you'll get apart from reaction based are the order of reactivities and some like trivia. You know, why is this the preferred method? Things like that. Why can't you use H2SO4 for secondary, tertiary, stuff like that? Okay. All right. Now let's get to the next methods of preparation. Alcohols ho gaya, abhi hydrocarbons. So that's alkanes, alkenes, alkynes. From hydrocarbons, first we go with alkanes. Alkanes, again, the most straightforward method you can think of is alkanes ka formula kya hai?
CnH2n+2.
There you go. So it's just plain carbons and hydrogens, right? If I take ethane, CH3CH3, in place of hydrogen, I need halogen because that's what alkyl halides are. So free radical halogenation is one way you can do it. This, you guys have studied free radical substitution here. If I take methane, CH4 in the presence of chlorine, halogenation here, you take a halogen. Free radical here, you need energy to break those bonds. Do it in the presence of sunlight. You get CH3Cl plus HCl. This is when you control it, but this keeps going on and on. The mechanism and all, we have done it in grade 11. Do you guys remember or do you want me to do it again?
I remember it partially. Like if it's like there are two types in which like homo and then hetero. And then homo mein it's like equally divided or something. And then hetero mein it's like towards the stronger one. Yeah, somewhat I remember.
Yeah. No, do you remember free radical halogenation? Free radical substitution. ये वाला रिएक्शन हैलोजेंस के साथ वाला रिएक्शन इसका मैकेनिज्म 3 स्टेप्स है इनिशिएशन प्रोपगेशन टर्मिनेशन अगर याद नहीं है तो आई विल डिस्कस दिस इफ यू थिंक लाइक यू कैन कैच अप यू रिमेंबर इट देन वी कैन गो नादर यस
Okay, I got it.
Arya, Smira, Sia, Arnav, what about you guys?
Yes, ma'am, I remember like most of it.
So this gives a question, like basically this reaction, if you remember it, it's going to give you a mixture of alkyl halides. Why? Can anyone answer?
Multiple products are formed.
That's what
reaction, multiple products are formed.
Yes, that's what it means. Mixture, matlab, mixture of multiple products. Why?
You don't know which two free radicals may combine.
Yes. So, because it is a free radical mechanism. Free radicals are when the bond breaks, like suppose you have carbon, hydrogen, or carbon-carbon, jo bhi hai. When the bond breaks equally, single bond matlab do electrons hai na. So when the bond breaks such that each carbon gets one electron, abhi octet complete nahi hua. So this is very, 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 very dangerous. It is highly reactive. So it'll react with whatever first atom or molecule it's going to bump against. And that's not something you can control because these are very tiny and you just have all of them in a test tube. Right? So you can't predict, you know, if I have a CH3 radical because C and H broke, you don't know whether this is going to bump into another CH3 radical. Is it going to bump into a chlorine radical? Is it going to bump into HCl? Or is it going to bump into, you know, another methane molecule? you don't know how the reaction is going to take place. You can't even control it, which is why you get a mixture of alkyl halides. If it's like a one mark question, mention this word, free radical mechanism. Like, it's a free radical substitution mechanism is what is followed here. Which is why, yeah, like propagation step, you know, you get multiple products. So if your aim is to create only chloroform or only chloromethane, any one alkyl halide, your yield is going to be low. So this is an example, especially if you use like higher alkanes, yahan pe propane hai, you don't know where the radical is going to be formed. It can bump into this carbon. If it bumps into this carbon, you get this product. If it bumps into this carbon, you get this product. Yahan pe Cl substitute hua. So you just simply can't control it. So yeah, this is not really preferred method of creating haloalkanes. This is the worst method of creating haloalkanes. Can you see that? Yeah. So this is one. Next. Alkanes ho gaya, alkenes. So alkenes, see, alkenes are those with double bond, right? So it's C double bond C. Yahan pe kuch bhi ho sakta hai, hydrogen ho sakta hai, it can be a longer chain. You add HX. Now this is an addition reaction. Kyunki double bond mein, one bond is breaking and the H and the X is being added to each of these carbons. See, the original is unchanged. Nothing is displaced. Extra atoms are being added here. That's why it is addition reaction. This also we had studied last year when you were doing alkenes. Do you guys remember Markovnikov and anti-Markovnikov rules? Yes, no? Like, you guys need to answer. If you don't remember it, it's quite important. I will repeat it. If you remember it, I will take it for granted and we'll go forward.
Miss, could you repeat it?
Okay. So, Markovnikov addition. So, default is Markovnikov, okay? By default, Markovnikov addition will take place. Markovnikov rule, iska matlab hai, abhi add ho raha hai HX, right? Hydrogen will get added to the atom where there's more number of hydrogens. Think of it as, you know, if you're going to a party, you would mingle with your friends, right? Before you go and meet strangers. So hydrogen will want to go to where there's more number of hydrogens. So whenever you have an asymmetrical alkene, like yahan pe if you see double bond ke yahan pe you have CH and yahan pe CH2 hai. Hydrogen will go towards the carbon which has more hydrogens. So the CH2 will become CH3 and the nucleophile gets added to the one with lesser hydrogens. So the X will be added over here. So in this case, HBr at the rate, Br will be over here. Now, anti-Markovnikov, this happens only if there's peroxide present. So in the question, if you're given a reagent, see whether there is a peroxide. Peroxide, it can happen in, like, it can be represented in multiple ways. Either they can give you outright ki H2O2 is there along with HBr, or they can write it as O2 2-, this is the peroxide ion. Or they can give you any other compound with a peroxide in it. So just look for O2 2- or H2O2. If that is there, iska opposite hoga. Which means hydrogen, which is supposed to go to H2, will not go to H2, it will go to the one with the lesser number of hydrogen atoms. So CH jo hai, that became CH2. And X jo hai, in this case Br, that gets added to the other carbon atom. So Br is added over here. Now because it is the opposite of Markovnikov rule, it's called anti-Markovnikov addition. Other name for it, because it happens only when there's peroxide, it's called peroxide effect. Yet another name for it, it's also called Kharosh effect. Three names to it. ठीक है, got it? So its mechanism and all like we discussed in grade 11. Check notes. Agar chahiye to I'll just like I'll send you guys the mechanism for this. But unless you're asked for mechanism, you won't really be asked for it so much. You'll be asked to predict the products and everything. So you just need to remember this rule. This is not special only for HX. It can be for the addition of H2O. It can be for any H and a nucleophile. So if H2O use kar rahe, to hydrogen will get added one place and the remaining OH will be added to the other place. You'll learn about this when we look at preparation of alcohols. Yeah. Abhi, because we are talking about alkyl halides, we are studying in the context of HX. So, Marconi curve rule, if you want to note it down. So, hydrogen added to a carbon that has more number of hydrogens. Agar dono carbon mein equal amount of hydrogens hai, toh it's symmetrical. Like there it won't make any difference wherever it's added. This is relevant only if it has different number of hydrogens when it's not symmetrical. Hydrogen added to the carbon that has more hydrogens, which means that the remaining Cl, Br, I, Jo, Bf, that gets added to the other part of the carbon atom. Anti-Marconi curve is opposite of Marconi curve rule. So logically, it can make sense of it. This particular addition is important only because of this. You'll be asked about, you know, predict the major product, minor product, and all of that. Let me know if you want to keep it, otherwise I'll go forward. So, agar HX liya, so ek side X add hua, you get mono haloalkane. Instead of HX, if you take Cl2, Br2, same reaction, same mechanism, except the same atom is added on both sides. So you end up getting vicinal dihalides. Now here, Marconi curve, anti-Marconi curve does not matter. Why?
Because it's a symmetrical alkene.
No, even if I take propene for that matter, CH3, CH1, CH2, and let's say I add bromine, Br2. What would be the product I get for this?
CH3, CHBr, CH2Br.
Yes.
On both sides, there is one.
Yeah. Who cares which bromine atom goes where? Like, it's the same thing, end of the thing, right? So here, all those rules does not matter. Both of them are adjacent to each other. We end up with vicinal dihalides. Do you guys remember this? Bromination is used in detecting double bonds. Why?
It's test for unsaturation because the brown color gets discharged.
Correct. Why do you not use chlorine or iodine in this case?
Chlorine has a very light yellow color. It might as well be colorless.
There you go. If you want a test, you need an observable change. Bromine being like dark brown, you can easily figure out when it becomes colorless. So that's why bromination is used. Okay.
Ma'am, bromination has CCl4 also, right?
Yeah. So that's used as a medium. Like usually acid-base reactions, you use it in, you do it in water, right? So you need a medium to be able to do these things. You use CCl4 as a medium. Why do we use CCl4 in this particular reaction? Can you figure out? What kind of compounds are alkenes?
And a non-polar solvent.
Non-polar solvent, absolutely. That's why you use CCl4. And because it's saturated, we know it's not going to react with alkene or the bromine. It's a good solvent. Mera is done. Yes. See you, Arnav, finish noting. Ritu still writing. Arnav, you also let me know. Okay, Mera is done. I'll just write CCl4 solvent for bromination. So this is all for hydrocarbons. Haloalkanes ke liye, we use addition reaction for alkenes, for mono and for di. And agar alkanes use kar rahe ho, it's free radical substitution. Alkynes use karne pe, again, there's a triple bond, right? So even if you add, you end up getting like an alkene with a halogen substituted in it, addition reaction. So you get a haloalkene. And if you do one more addition, you may get like gem dihalides. Yeah. Cool. Next, halogen exchange reaction. Again, just like the name suggests, you already have a halogen in the reactant and you're exchanging it for another halogen. So you usually use this method to prepare alkyl iodides because iodides being the most reactive, they can substitute other halogens in the compound. So you take either RCl or RBi. It's like your single displacement reaction. Use NaI, I substitutes here, then you do it. Why dry acetone? Anyone? No? Again, non-polar solvent. If it is polar, it'll be ionized, like it's written right here. So NaX precipitates in dry acetone. Like you don't want this to remain ionized, right? So you want to push this forward. You want to take this out of the reaction. Best way by doing that is like just take it out of the solution, let it precipitate. Uske liye, if you use water, it'll be dissolved, reversible reaction ho sakta hai. Instead, if you use a non-polar solvent like dry acetone, it'll push forward. Oh, here's a question. What is this an application of? Who remembers?
Common ion effect.
Common ion effect, okay. See, I got it. Very good. Common ion effect. Again, you're not using a common ion, right? Like dry acetone does not have a common ion to RX or NaI. You're taking away the product to push the equilibrium to the right side.
Oh, I know. Is it the Shadius?
How are you taking away the product? Isn't it still like in the...
You're precipitating out, right? So solution mein nahi hai. So these ions are not available to get into the reaction. So Le Chatelier's principle. Reducing the concentration of the product. So you like this one to produce more and more product.
I didn't get how, because we studied in like the physical equilibrium part, that even if there's precipitate, it's part of the equilibrium because it keeps like reacting, right?
When it is capable of dissolving. Yahan pe solvent hum dry acetone le rahe because we don't want this to dissolve. So as soon as you have Na plus interacting with an X minus, there's nothing to keep these ions apart. If you put it in water, there's dissociation, there's hydration and solvation effects, right? Because it's polar. Yahan pe koi polarity nahi hai. These two will attract each other. They'll form NaX salt and they'll precipitate out.
This how I still understand how it's an application of Le Chatelier's principle.
What is Le Chatelier's principle? Do you remember?
Yeah, increase if the reaction moves forward with either pressure conditions, or it talks about endothermic, exothermic change. Concentration,
right? Yahan pe, you're reducing the concentration of the product. You're taking away the product because concentration of Na plus, concentration of X minus is reducing because Na plus X minus available nahi hai reaction ke liye.
So you're decreasing the concentration of the product side so that the reaction moves forward.
Correct. So this, when you use iodide, like iodide preparation ke liye, it's called Finkelstein reaction. Abhi tak humne fluorides ke baare mein baat nahi kiya. So if you want to prepare alkyl fluorides, you use metal fluorides, don't use highly reactive ones. Use silver fluoride, mercuric fluoride, mercuric fluoride, cobalt fluoride. Sb is antimony. So group 15 element. Yeah. So fluorides ke liye, the name of the reaction is Swartz reaction. Finkelstein is for iodides, Swartz is for fluorides. So that's okay. We have preparation of haloarenes. Cool. Set up the burning. Okay, everyone's done? Cool. Hello, arenes. Basically, you need arene, matlab aromatic compound. So think of benzene and benzene derivatives. Pure benzene ho sakta hai, ya fir toluene ho sakta hai, or any other benzene derivatives. Phenol, nitrobenzene, aniline, koi bhi hai. One way to prepare haloalkenes, haloarenes, which is electrophilic substitution. This is a very common characteristic of benzene and benzene derivative compounds. You will come across this in every single chapter. 11th mein benzene ke bare mein you studied. Here also haloarenes mein you're studying this electrophilic substitution. Properties of chlorobenzene maybe you'll come across electrophilic substitution. And every other chapter, properties of phenol, preparation of phenol, properties of aldehydes, like how to prepare aldehydes, properties of benzaldehyde, properties of benzoic acid. Every single benzene-related compound you study, you're going to come across electrophilic substitution. This is going to be one of the most repetitive reactions you're going to study, okay? Now, how many of you remember electrophilic substitution? Okay. Arya, Sanskriti, Smera, Sia, Arna?
Not much.
Okay. So what do you remember about it? Like just roughly the reaction alone or like... I remember the reaction, but I don't remember the mechanism. Is it like that? So what parts of it do you guys remember?
I remember like the basic reactions, but like one or two, I've forgotten what like the reagents were, like the specifications and whether the group was like orthodirecting or like metadirecting and stuff like that.
Okay. So I'll go over this once. Okay. I'll do the reaction and we'll come back to the slide. Okay, so we are talking about electrophilic substitution. This is not very complicated, pretty self-explanatory. The first thing, focus on the substitution part of it. So basically, is reaction mein, something is substituting something else. So benzene ke case mein, always something is substituting hydrogen. So benzene is what? C6H6, right? You have a benzene ring, double bonds here, and each carbon is attached to a hydrogen. So one of these hydrogens is always the thing that is substituted. Now, what is taking place of hydrogen? It's electrophilic substitution. So it's always an electrophile. Do you guys remember what is an electrophile?
Electron deficient.
Electrophile, like philic is electron liking. It likes electrons because it itself does not have electrons. So usually it's a positively charged thing. Yeah, electron deficient, it does not have enough electrons. Mechanism always is the same thing in all the cases. The first step is generation of electrophile. Like substitute karne ke liye electrophile chahiye na. So the first step always is the electrophile is generated, made, prepared, produced. Let's call this E plus. E for electrophile. Electrophile deficient hai, so always has a positive charge. Then the next step is this E plus attacks benzene. And the third step is, agar hydrogen ko substitute kar raha hai, toh we need to get rid of hydrogen, right? So that electrophile can take its place. So that happens in the third step. So that's removal of proton. Proton matlab H+. every single context, when we talk about proton in reactions, proton is attacking or proton is getting removed, it is by default H plus only. We're not talking about positively charged particles in the nucleus, basically H plus. Now, let's talk about it in context of this particular reaction, chlorobenzene ke liye. The others, it's okay. Like when we talk about those reactions, tabhi you can come, you can study about it. Now let's worry about only this. So generation of electrophile, chlorobenzene ke liye, the reagent that you use is always Cl2 or Br2, like whatever you want to prepare, chlorobenzene, bromobenzene, whatever you want to prepare, plus a Lewis acid. Most commonly you take AlCl3. Alternates are you can also take, like agar bromine kar rahe ho, you can take FeBr2. So basically you need a Lewis acid. So when this happens, like how is the electrophile generated? These are electron deficient, right? Lewis acid ka purpose ye hai ki they get attracted to lone pair of electrons. So they get, these guys get attracted to the lone pair of electrons present on chlorine bromine and they form a complex. Agar AlCl3 and Cl2 use kar rahe ho, so you get AlCl4-. Square brackets are important because there are special type of compounds called coordination compounds, also called complex compounds. So this is also something you'll be studying about this year in a future chapter. You have AlCl4-. And remaining, agar one chlorine has gone along with its electrons, that's what this negative charge is. So dusra does not have electrons, right? So you get Cl plus. If we are talking about FeBr2 and Br, then this becomes FeBr3- plus Br plus. Context, whatever you're using in this particular reaction. Then, second step is that, like, let me highlight this. So this is your electrophile. जिसपे भी पॉजिटिव चार्ज है दैट्स योर इलेक्ट्रोफाइल दैट्स व्हाई वी कॉल्ड इट ई प्लस सो द नेक्स्ट स्टेप दिस इलेक्ट्रोफाइल अटैक्स बेंजीन सो बेंजीन रिंग ऑन द कार्बन्स. It's all completely, perfectly symmetrical. Koi bhi ek hydrogen ko attack karega, doesn't matter which, however you note it down, basically attacks one of the hydrogens. So plus, let's say Cl plus. Okay. So chlorine with a positive charge, again, chlorine is highly, highly electronegative, cannot stand positive charge. It needs electrons, gets attracted to the electron-rich benzene ring. So this is not required yet. We don't care about this yet. So let's say chlorine attacks this double bond. Okay. Double bond hai, matlab extra electrons hai. Positive charge is attracted to the negative charge of the electrons. Again, mechanisms are nothing but we are seeing where electrons move and which electrons are attracted to which positive charges. That's all mechanisms are. So positive charge gets attracted to the negative electrons here. So as a result, this is formed. Yahan pe double bond is not disturbed. Lekin, let's say chlorine gets attached to this carbon. It takes the electrons from the double bond. So is carbon pe there is a positive charge now. reach till here, like, and then just observe what is happening, where the electrons are moving. If there's any confusion, I will repeat it. I'll show the electron movements. Otherwise, if you got the hang of it, then we'll go to the next step.
Ma'am, does it have to attack at that carbon? Can't it attack at the carbon where the one hydrogen is shown?
Wherever. That's what I said, right? Like, hydrogen is there and attached to all the carbons. Kahi bhi ho sakta hai. Benzene is perfectly symmetrical. All carbons are equal. This thing, so anywhere is fine. The point is, it is attacking any one of the carbon atoms over here. But the more important point is, wherever it attacks, now because that carbon is forming a bond with chlorine, it will not have the double bond anymore. So don't make a mistake there. So if at all this chlorine attacks this particular carbon, yahan pe attach hua, to ye double bond is not disturbed, this double bond will not be there. So just be careful of that, like note the movement of electrons. Chlorine is getting attached there, matlab, it's taking the electrons from the double bond. So that double bond will not be there. So now you need to remember that chlorine is getting added here. It is still intact with all the hydrogens, like all the hydrogens are still present. This is still C6H6Cl+. Now benzene may resonance continuously chal raha hai na. So just because this chlorine is here, that's not going to get stopped. Ye positive charge hai, it's going to attract the electrons. Like carbon is like, hey, I'm positive, I need more electrons. It's going to pull on these electrons. So those resonating structures will continuously be there. The chlorine is attached here. This double bond is not disturbed. But because this positively charged carbon is attracting these pi electrons, yahan pe double bond form hua, the positive charge migrates here. So this again goes all over the ring. And when it reaches this particular carbon, let's say this attracts this electron. Ye double bond form hua. Then this has shifted over here, which means that yahan pe positive charge hai, yahan pe chlorine already attached hai. Yahan pe ek hydrogen hai. Now, removal of proton ke liye, in the third step, what is happening is, during this resonance, यहाँ पे पॉजिटिव चार्ज है, यहाँ पे Cl है, यहाँ पे हाइड्रोजन है. हाइड्रोजन इज अ टाइनी टाइनी एटम. इट ओनली हैज वन प्रोटॉन एंड वन इलेक्ट्रॉन दैट इज शेयरिंग. सो इट्स इजी फॉर हाइड्रोजन टू ब्रेक अवे. सो नाउ दिस पॉजिटिवली चार्ज कार्बन इज लाइक, ओके, आई वांट इलेक्ट्रॉन्स, आई एम लैकिंग इलेक्ट्रॉन्स. सो इट्स गोना पुल दीज इलेक्ट्रॉन्स हियर एंड लेट गो ऑफ H+. Like hydrogen has lost electrons, so it gains that positive charge. And finally, what you're left with is chlorobenzene. Benzene with one of the hydrogens substituted with the chlorine atom. Clear? Like, did this bring back memories?
Yes, ma'am.
This is like your basic electrophilic substitution for benzene. Once everybody's done, then we'll look at special cases when, like, the ortho para directing and all those other cases. Noting Sia, Ritu, Arnav are done. Sia, Smira, Sanskriti, let me know when you guys are done. Okay. Aditya, we are done. Sanskriti, Smira, and Sia. What about you guys? Yes, done. Okay.
Ma'am, I reacted.
Oh, okay, sorry, I must have missed it. Okay. Sanskriti, are you also finished? Hello? Sanskriti, are you there? Connection issues. All right. Now, if it is simple benzene, this is the reaction that it's going to undergo. And because all the carbons are equal, symmetrical here, doesn't matter. One of the hydrogens is replaced by the chlorine. Now, what if it was a substituted benzene? So, when it is substituted, you need to see what is substituted there. OH group ho sakta hai, CH3 ho sakta hai, COH ho sakta hai, koi bhi ho sakta hai, right? Here I just took an OH group as an example. When it is substituted, again, like that substituent gets into the resonance, like it's going to affect the resonance. In the case of phenol, this is what it looks like. Lone pair of electrons and oxygen, when it goes into resonance, you can see these are the different resonating structures. Now, when an electrophile attacks, remember electrophile is E+. Jo bhi hai, electron liking hai wo. Where is it likely to attack? Can it attack anywhere? Like, are all the possibilities equal? Or is there probability of it attacking? Yeah. Yeah, Ritu?
It would attack like ortho and para.
There you go. So whenever you have electrons adding to the resonance, like OH ke lone pair is adding to the resonance, yahan pe double bond ho raha hai. You can see this negative charge being concentrated here. Let me change the color. This negative charge being concentrated in this position and this position. So whenever you have OH like electron donating groups or electron like groups that add electrons to the ring, so you have OH, you have halogens, you have alkyl groups like toluene, ethyl, methyl, jo bhi hai. You have ether. All of these will give you ortho and para products. And when
so these are electron donating?
Electron donating, right? So think of it as like even amine for that matter. So usually these are the groups that have extra pair of electrons. They have lone pair of electrons or they have electron donating nature. So alkyl groups are electron donating. These others have extra pair of electrons. Okay. So these groups will result in ortho para products. So as a quick hack kind of way, the way I remember it is, if it reminds you of a base, except for halogen, rest of it, NH2 amines are very similar to NH3, ammonia, which is like basic nature, right? OH minus is a base. So things that have extra electrons to give directly and contribute to the resonance, ortho para products. But if it reminds you of an acid, so nitro group, COOH group, esters, COOR, then what else do we have? Amides, anything that has a C double bond O, even aldehydes, ketones, amides. So things that remind you of acids, they basically take electrons away from the ring. So you call them deactivating groups. So they deactivate the benzene ring. So these result in meta products. So I'll show you why these result in meta products. All of these groups, the kind of resonance structures they undergo is exactly like what is shown in phenol here. You have negative charge concentrated in ortho and para positions. Now in these case, because they're taking like pura arrows will be in the opposite direction. Like agar yahan pe NO2 hai, it's gonna take away electrons from the ring. So yahan pe positive charge aa jayega. So that's why they are meta directing. I'll show you the resonance in those cases also. It'll be clear. Can I take away this image, guys? Can I switch to the other thing?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am.
So let's say instead of phenol, we look at resonance in nitrobenzene. A nice big image. This should be. That's a good one. There you go. So you can see nitrobenzene mein kya ho raha hai. Nitro is NO2. It is taking electrons away from the ring. So phenol, chlorobenzene, toluene, jis pe yahan pe like positive, like negative charge tha na. In case of deactivating groups, you get a positive charge instead. So if we have an electrophile that wants to attack, where can it attack? So positive charge will repel these positive charge, right? So the only place that is available for it to attack is meta position. the only place which has extra electrons that it can take is in the meta positions. Okay. So that's why nitro, you have COH, S, like anything that has C double bond O. So C double bond O, OH, C double bond O, OR, aldehyde group, CHO, ketone. So all of these, and then you have nitro, or okay, electron withdrawing. These are the main things. When we come across those compounds, we'll deal with them. Most common, these are the things. They're all meta-directed. Okay, Sanskriti, Smira, Arnav, Sia, when you guys are done, just let me know. Arnav, Smira. Okay. Now that you guys got the hang of this, go proceed. Let's say this is toluene. When I make it react with Cl2 in the presence of AlCl3, what are the products I get? If you want, you can give the names, type the names in the chat, or you can, like, if you want to draw the structures and send it on WhatsApp, that also works. Either way. Ritu, is that the only product you get? No, like we're using a Lewis acid here, no? So free radical halogenation nahi hoga yahan pe. Smira. Adit, yes, absolutely. Adit got it. Arya got it.
Not exactly like how we did in the other two.
Other two, which other two?
like before, like you have to take the positions of ortho and para.
Yeah.
You don't have to do anything else to it, right?
No. Oh, Sia sent the. Yeah, Sia is also absent. No. So one, like position one is where CH3 is there. So it'll be 2 and 4. Okay, just to clarify. Abhi badhamne. Like CH3 is electron donating. It's going to activate the ring. So alkyl groups are all ortho para directing. Okay, so CH3, this is one product, orthochlorobenzene, toline, and you get ortho, like parachlorotoline. Yeah. Now, you get both of them in equal quantities. Meta is going to be a minor product. It is practically negligible. These two are again completely different products, right? Ortho and para. They're isomers of each other, but they're like different compounds. So how do you separate ortho and para from each other? Any ideas? Based on the difference in structures, what can you think of? How do you separate both of these? CIS. It is based on that property, but can you think of what process you will use? Yeah,
boiling, melting point.
There you go. So there is going to be a difference in their melting, boiling points. So what is the method of separation that you will use, making use of that difference? So point one, like you have orthochlorotoline and you have parachlorotoline. They can be separated due to difference in melting points. Two questions. Okay. One, what process will you use? And two, why is there a difference in melting points?
Oh, we are supposed to answer these two questions. Yeah.
Give it a try. I'll give you answers anyway, but I want to see like what you guys can think of. You have studied this, okay? Like, think of, okay, I'll give you hints. Think of like intermolecular forces, van der Waals forces that you studied in States of Matter. And what process, like you've been studying that since grade 9. Think of that. Yes. Sia got it for both of them. Nice. Well done, Sia. Come on, guys. Sia is able to do it. Like, rest of you. Yeah,
one, I think, if I remember, like, for the para, intermolecular forces are more than ortho and meta. So that is why the difference.
Why is it more? Difference matlab ek zyada ek kam hoga. They are not equal. But why?
It takes like more amount of energy to like melt it, and because of which.
Same thing you said it in different words. Ritu
is it called?
Hydrogen bond in ortho position. That is definitely a factor, but more than that, there's a different factor. Which one? यहाँ पे इंटरमोलिक्यूलर हाइड्रोजन बॉन्डिंग होगा यहाँ पे इंट्रा, बट लाइक कार्बन हाइड्रोजन उतना इलेक्ट्रोनेगेटिव नहीं है ना, सो इट्स मोर ऑफ अ माइनर फैक्टर. लुक केयरफुली बिटवीन बोथ दी स्ट्रक्चर्स, लाइक पोजिशन इज डिफरेंट बट विजुअली क्या डिफरेंस लग रहा है दोनों में.
Ma'am, what was the question? One, like you wrote what process, but what process of what is it asking?
Like what process are you going to use for separating? What are na? Evaporation, filtration, distillation, centrifugation, crystallization. Like there are a few that you studied about bahut pehle. Okay, at least you're like, okay, why difference in melting point? You can see, para esme, this molecule is symmetrical. So due to that symmetry, remember Van der Waals forces, agar symmetrical hai, if you know, the molecules can crystallize nicely with each other, isliye unka, there you go, and there is a difference in MP as it is closely fitted in crystal lattice due to the symmetry. Yeah. Symmetry in the parachlorotoluene, which is why iska MP will be greater. You guys have gotten the logic of like it correctly. Isme definitely zyada melting point hoga. Kyun hoga? Because intermolecular forces are more. But where is that coming from? Root of that is basically the symmetry. And to a minor extent, Ritu is correct. Hydrogen bonding also would play a role. Not as much as the symmetry in the crystal lattice. Okay. And process, you guys are gonna like facepalm once I say this. Distillation.
Well, we didn't do processes, I remember.
Bachpan se you were thinking like fractional distillation, like ekko evaporate kar lo, like boil it off, then condense it. One will boil easily because iska boiling point or melting point is lesser than the other ones. All right. These are like the important point when it comes to preparation, like directly by introducing halogens to the hydrocarbon. There's another method of preparation from aniline. Okay, let's get back to that. Where is it? Here. Let's see if you've covered everything. Electrophilic substitution, this is a basic reaction. Agar substituted hai, like if you're using toluene, phenol, something like that, then ortho and para isomers, you're gonna get it, which can be separated due to difference in melting points. Okay, reaction with iodine is reversible. Because again, carbon-iodine bond can be broken easily, which is why you use a oxidizing agent to remove this byproduct. Again, Le Chatelier's principle, you remove one of the products, in this case, with a further reaction, then it'll be pushed in the, like you'll get more of this product, required product. And as always, you can prepare fluorine because it's very reactive and violent. That's always the case with fluorine. Next, amines. This is Sandmeyer's reaction. This is another important reaction. You will study it again when you study about amines. Specifically, this is about aniline. Aniline, as an introduction, it's basically benzene with NH2. This particular compound is called aniline. It's just the name of this compound. NH2 functional group is called an amine. So when amine attached to benzene ring is aniline. The steps for this, again, it's a multi-step process. First step, you dissolve aniline in cold aqueous mineral acid. Usually you want nitrous acid, HNO2. Again, HNO2, you prepare it in situ by using sodium nitrite and aqueous HCl. You want to ensure that it is cold. So this reaction takes place in, like, you want it to be cold conditions. So this should be nitrite, you guys. The correction here. Sodium nitrite, mineral acid. This produces a diazonium salt. So the structure that you see here, salt, because you can see it's ionic, you have a positive charge and a negative charge, cation, anion. So this particular structure is called a diazonium salt. So whenever you have like pure nitrogen attached to it, that's like an azo group. And because you have N2, that's diazo. EM showing that it's positive, salt, positive, negative. And final step, you mix this salt with cuprous chloride or bromide, the cuprous halide, to get your haloalkane or haloarene. So in this particular reaction, this is the important bit. So depending on whether you want chlorobenzene or bromobenzene, you take that particular copper salt. This does not matter. Like, yahan pe HCl low, HBr, like usually you always take HCl. That does not decide what you're going to get finally. What decides is what you take in the final step. Because yahan pe jo bhi anion hai, that basically substitutes the azo group over here. So your byproduct, apart from your organic compound, is N2 gas, which escapes out. So N triple bond N gets released as N2. This particular anion from copper is the one that gets attached to the benzene ring. So if you take copper, like cuprous chloride, you get aryl chloride. If you take bromide, you get aryl bromide. So pay attention here. This is quite important. Yahan pe HCl liya. So isliye chlorobenzene hai. That is not the case. What matters is what you take over here. Whether it's chloride or bromide, this will remain constant. Nitrite salt in cold mineral acid, you get a diazonium salt. Then what you do with this diazonium salt will decide what you get here. Okay? It's called Sandmeyer's reaction. You will come across Sandmeyer's reaction again when you study about amines in possible term 2, like end of the year. So if you see, we've talked about cuprous chloride, cuprous bromide. If you want iodide, I'm just writing it over here. So for iodide, so you shake or mix the diazonium salt. With KI.
Okay. For iodine, but for others, we don't need KI.
You're using the copper salt, no? Either CPL okay. Or CUBR. Yeah.
So, but like only for iodine, we use KI.
Yeah. For iodide, you use KI. For fluorine, you use again a different thing. Like, I'll give you different cases of this. Okay. Guys, let me know when you are done. Okay, three people done. Aditya is done. Ritu and Arya is also done. Okay. Sanskriti have not. I don't know what happened to Sanskriti's person. Just a second, guys. All right. Now, some extra notes about this. I'll tell you guys. So you've noted down everything, right? You've noted down the reagent also here. So for Sandmeyer's reaction, you're using cuprous chloride or cuprous bromide, right? Of course, instead of taking a copper salt, you happen to take mixture of Cu powder. Cu powder. So copper powder plus HX. Forgive the writing, there's some delay flag here. You guys able to follow? Like, is this clear? Legible at least? Like,
did something happen to the handwriting? Because before it was looking smooth. Now it's like when you're doing it with a mouse or a trackpad.
I am using a trackpad because there is some lag. I'm not able to write properly. But it doesn't have to be beautiful as long as you guys are able to understand it.
Yeah, understood.
So if you're using, so like Sandmeyer's reaction mein kya ho raha hai? You're using, last step mein you're using cuprous chloride or cuprous bromide. You're using a salt directly, right? Instead of that, if you are using copper powder plus an acid like HBr or HCl, in this case, the reaction is called Gatterman's reaction. Yeah. And the second point is, abhi tak we've dealt with iodine ke liye potassium iodide, chloride bromide ke liye we have Sandmeyer's reaction, Gatterman's reaction. If we want to produce fluorides, if you want to produce fluorobenzene, for fluorobenzene, use fluoroboric acid. Instead of a copper salt, you will use fluoroboric acid. In this case, then the reaction is called, this is a little balls, Schumann reaction. German names. This you won't be asked, but like just in case to cover all the halogens, just giving you the information. The most commonly asked ones are Gatterman's reaction and Sandmeyer's reaction. This is what you'll come across. And iodides ke case mein use Ki. That's the important part. It's just to complete the thing. Yeah. And that's it for all the preparation methods. Okay. Once you're noting it down, open Flipper. We'll do some questions based on this. Ritu, Cu powder plus HX instead of, it's not instead of HX, instead of CuX or Cu2X2. Who else? Somebody else had just called. Yeah.
No.
Are you supposed to open zipper?
Yes. Once you're done, enter the live code. Hey, Smira, Sia, Adita here.
The questions in these are also like how we had for physics, like all in one, like mix of all, right?
Arit's here, Ritu is here, Arya is not here. Sanskriti, hi, what happened?
Ma'am, actually my mobile is not working out of battery.
Okay. So what will you do now? We with questions. Kaise kar?
It's not even switching on.
But abhi tak kya hua? Like I haven't like heard from you for a while.
I guess ma'am, just because the I was connected to the mobile and suddenly the battery went off, so I had to connect it to the Wi-Fi. So it was taking a while.
Hey. Abhi theek hai. I'm talking about when we were doing like electrophilic substitution and all that. Have you noted it down? Have you followed?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. Smira is here, Sia is here, Arnav is here. Theek hai. Just put it for charging. Jab bhi load ho jayega, enter the code and join in. Okay.
Yes.
Okay. I'm starting. Okay. First question. Just to give you, okay. There. Read all the options carefully and answer, huh? Arya, can't see the question. Kya ho raha hai, Arya? Can you just show your...
When this is good, A and B.
Ma'am, this happens every time.
The options have been jumbled.
Okay.
Yeah, there's some jumbling issues. So I don't want to get it wrong with double confidence.
Option... Okay, I'll write... Like, option A is red P plus Br2. Option B is HCl plus ZnCl2. Option C is both A and B. And option D is H2SO4 plus Ki. Arya, can you just hold up your screen to the video? Because I want to see what, like, is it? Oh, okay. When did you install the app?
The first time I attended class, and I told like Rohit sir also, and yeah, I can solve the other questions, but every time I join the live thing, that time I can't see the questions. So last, like, yeah, I Even in physics, I couldn't do anything.
Okay. Yeah. So Lohit sir, मतलब last week है. Okay. Not sorted. Like you've tried uninstalling, reinstalling the latest.
Yeah.
Okay. Which are you using Android?
Yeah.
Okay.
I send the details like of the phone also to sir.
Oh, it's bad, no? Okay. Let's see. Okay, 4 people have answered. 1 person, I'm guessing that's you, Arya, who's not answered. Arnav, did you read all the options?
Yes, I misclicked.
Okay, all right. Nice. So highest, isn't it? Yeah. Ritu, you did double confidence. C also did double confidence. Good. Arnav, are yeah, next. Which reaction should be the fastest with benzene in the presence of anhydrous AlCl3? This is an application of this one, electrophilic substitution.
Miss, I didn't submit the answer, but still I got it wrong.
Oh. Okay, you select it and then you click on submit. So try selecting another option, no? Or is it showing as it's submitted for you?
It shows the solution directly and it shows like I have not submitted any.
You've not selected. Like, I also can see that nobody has answered yet. Okay, 1 person has answered. Okay. Look at the options. Think of what you are comparing in this situation.
The other way around. I mean the other way around.
Arya, like instead of like, do you want to exit the live class and start like your regular practice session instead? It'll be the same questions anyway. Try it. उसने आंसर किया. सो ऋतु एंड स्मेरा हैव आंसर्ड. सिया, अर्णव, benzene and anhydrous AlCl3 मतलब electrophilic substitution, electrophile produce हो रहा है मतलब positive charge. Now look at cation क्या produce हो रहा है इधर. सबका structures एक जैसा ही है. You have CH3, CH and then halogen and CH3. The only difference is एक में that you have chlorine, bromine, iodine and fluorine. So you just need to figure out which one is the fastest मतलब in which case is the bond going to break most easily. So between fluorine, chlorine, bromine, iodine, which would be the fastest? We had done this fairly. We discussed. Oh, Sia has answered. Arnav, you're still not able to select anything because I can't see that you answered here.
Yes, I can only see the solutions directly. And
you click on
not even the
by mistake. Wo bhi ho sakta
hai. No, ma'am.
No,
there is only one option down there. That is submit.
Oh. Yeah. The next one. Cool. Adit, did you figure out what happened here?
I knew what happened. I knew it. I was like, I go the other way around.
Okay. Let's see if you got it. next. Amongst the following, which one will not give the same product in the presence or absence of peroxide? Take some time to think about it.
Ma'am, but where's the double bond?
Double bond, like this is an amide, so double bond, just a sec, let me check the solution. I'll like just flag this question. Why can't I flag it? Can you guys flag it?
Yes, ma'am.
Okay, just flag this question. We'll go to the next one.
Flag it with what?
You need a reason to flag it.
Check options.
Like mention check options because the options are not making sense for peroxide. No, we haven't done reactions with amides, so I don't know that. Arya is saying it's not showing methods of preparation anymore.
Like I opened it, solve one question and then it just shut and disappeared.
Shut, matlab, did you go back to the home page? Did you?
Like, no, it automatically shut and brought me back to haloalkanes and haloalanes topic. And now it doesn't even show the preparation.
It's not even showing like completed or anything like that.
Yeah. It's not showing that category altogether.
Can you check in boost or revise? Next.
I can't go back from the report option.
Oh,
no, miss, it's not there.
If I close the app and open it again, will my live session end?
Ideally, you should like enter the code and join back like wherever you are. Try it and see what happens. Guys, is the image visible to whoever is looking at the question? Question may image. If you want to maximize it, click on the image. We have nitro and like isopropyl group there, two substituents with bromine in the presence of sunlight. This is a very good question. It touches on like 2-3 different topics. I'll do this on the whiteboard for the rest of you also so that everybody gets to see it. Okay. Smira and Ritu have answered. Before I discuss, I wanna, like, I'll put the question here. I wanna know your logic why you answered that. Okay. Okay, for everybody else, this is the reaction. Okay. So you have benzene ring. Yahan pe NO2 hai. And yahan pe we have an isopropyl group. This we're making it react with Br2 in the presence of sunlight. So yahan pe major product kya hoga? That's the reaction. Question. Okay, so Arya, Sia, Sanskriti, yeah. So this is the question. Try answering it. You want the options? I'll give you the options also. One option is call it A. Chat mein you can answer A, B, C, or D. Ritu, again, think of Markovnikov, anti-Markovnikov only if you have a double bond. Otherwise, that's not even in, you know, in consideration. Okay.
Wait, but our options are different in the sense like order. So even if for someone it's A, then it will be different.
See, those who are answering on the app, I know what you're answering. Those who are not answering on the app, chat box mein I need to give some alphabet, no? So I'll get to see what you answer. Ritu, yes. Close, but on the same lines. You're like 90% correct. This is one option.
I got it.
This is the next option. Here, instead of NO2, we have N2 plus Br minus, and this remains as it is. Third option is this. NO2 remains as it is, and Br is just in the corner. And fourth option is this. Same as third, but we have two of this. Okay, yahan pe Ritu, okay, Adit, you already answered yahan pe, theek hai. Oh. Sia, Smira, Arnav. Okay, Sia, I see that you found your way back. So five people answered. Yes. Arya, you answer over chat. Sanskriti, you also answer over chat. What do you think? Which one is?
Ma'am, I have joined the live one.
Oh, you
I
did? Even...
Yes, ma'am.
So fir yahan pe answer kar lena.
Ma'am, my answer was wrong though.
Oh, you have answered here. I see it. Okay. Arya, which one do you think is it?
I think C, but I'm not sure.
C. Okay. Ritu and Adit are the only people who have got it right. Okay, first, those who have answered B, Smira, Sia, and Arnav, why did you think it was B?
Ma'am, I did not understand. I just put any option to like submit the answer. Okay. I did not.
whichever look like odd one
out. Is it because H mu so free, like radical, so plus minus?
Yes. Free radical mein plus minus nahi hoga. So first step is identify kya reaction ho raha hai. Halogen sunlight matlab, there's only one answer, which is free radical reaction. So free radical substitution. Do you think free radical substitution will ever happen on NO2 group? Like, have you studied about it? Has it been there? So this you can completely ignore. Next, free radical substitution ke liye, do you think benzene will undergo free radical substitution?
No, ma'am.
No. This also you can completely ignore. So the only places where bromine can get substituted is the side chain, one of these three carbon atoms. Okay. So this is like a rule. Whenever you see a tertiary carbon, right? If you think that it is, it's going to have a nucleophilic substitution. Like if you think there is a carbocation or a free radical being formed, then wherever you have the free radical, because a tertiary carbocation and a tertiary free radical is the most stable. So whether it is carbocation or a carbon free radical, whichever it may be, tertiary carbon is the most stable, tertiary carbocation and tertiary free radical. So in this sort of a situation, even if you have a free radical being formed, like free radical ka hume kya pata, wherever the Br ka radical hits, that's going to turn into a free radical. Now, if Br ka radical hits this, it is going to rearrange itself to form a tertiary radical. Okay, because tertiary is the most stable. So these two will be formed, but here it specifically asks for major product, which is why this is the major product. So tertiary jo bhi hai, this carbon connected to carbon 1, carbon 2, carbon 3, or again, you come across secondary less stable than, like tertiary most stable followed by secondary followed by primary. Whichever is the most stable free radical, that's what it gets attracted towards. So the most carbon with the most branches, that's where your bromine is going to get substituted. Okay, clear?
Yes, ma'am.
Cool. Next.
Miss, can you explain why it's A again?
We'll just finish this and then we'll come back to this. Okay. Next question. I'll just write it down again, Arya, for your benefit.
What is Lucas reagent?
Oh, Lucas reagent is HCl and ZnCl2.
On the same thing. Okay.
This is the question. You have OH, CH2OH, in the presence of Lucas reagent. Eat it. Lucas reagent is HCl and ZnCl2O. Voila. Gives what product? Arya, work out the product on your own. If you can't figure it out, then I'll give you the options. Okay, who has answered? Do you guys get to see if your answer is correct or wrong as soon as you answer it or after I press next? Immediately, you know. Okay. This is a direct question. Like, iska funda humne discuss kiya, notes bhi likha. To be able to. Ritu and Sia have answered it. If it helps, write it down, refer to your notes. Again, this is the first set of questions you're answering, so it's okay to refer to your notes. Ritu, Sia, Adit have answered. So, Sanskriti, Smera, Arnav. Good. What sort of a reaction will you end up with HCl, ZnCl2 ke saath? And see what reagent, like you have OH groups, matlab alcohol hai. Smera, very close. Did you figure out why you're wrong, Smera?
No, I'm confused. Wait, why won't the OH one will be like?
This OH is directly attached to benzene ring. So, isko break kar sakte kya?
No, sorry.
Yeah. So, who else? Arnav answered. Cool. Arya, do you have your answer? You can dictate and then I can write.
Yeah, the OH and the CH2 will be replaced by Cl.
Okay. And what about this OH?
Yeah, that you because it's directly attached to benzene ring, I think the bond would be stronger, so it won't be that easy to break it. But I don't know if it forms like a minor product or something.
No, no minor product. This will remain as it is. So this is the final product.
But, miss, I clicked on the right answer, but the card's still wrong.
Click on the right answer, but niche. One thing, see that, you know, like if you hold your phone like this, kabhi kabhi, this might touch screen hai na, it might get sensitive. So be careful about that. Next time, be very, very careful and click on.
I still got it wrong, even if it's correct.
Okay, say how? Weird. I can see your name in like correct answers, Arna. I can see your name here also.
Yes, minus 20.
And here also. Tumhare do accounts kaise hai, Arna?
No, miss, I only have one.
Because I can see correct answer ke list mein your name is here. Weird.
Oh, red flag it then.
Which of the following yields only one type of monosubstituted chloroalkane upon chlorination? So Arya, your options are isobutane to cyclopentane. C is propane and D is n-butane. In charon mein se, in which case will you get only one product? On chlorination. So on chlorination, matlab Cl2 in the presence of sunlight, when you make it react with this, you need to get only one monosubstituted product, which is Hint, draw the structures. I can see all of you writing, so that's a good idea. Ritu, Arnav, now you got it. Correct answer, Abhi. Sia has also got it. Adit, Arya, Sanskriti. Okay, who is this? Adit, good. Sia, you are not very confident about this. How come?
I wasn't sure.
Like, did you just guess or
you just... No, I knew it would, but like, even when I go to click double confidence, it's like, what if it's not?
See, as long as your logic is sound, no, you will get the correct answer. So trust your logic more than don't click. Stop worrying about is it a correct answer or wrong answer. See whether you have applied the correct logic. Did you go the correct way or not? Sanskriti, Arya, and Smira. Kya hua? Who else? Smira, what happened?
Ma'am, I misclicked.
Okay. Arya answered, yes, that is absolutely correct. Sanskriti, what happened? You're the only one who's yet to answer. See, single product chahiye, multiple products nahi chahiye. In which case, substitution pe, it doesn't matter where it's substituted. All places are equal. That's what you need to do. Cyclopentane, yes. See, isobutane kya hai? It's something like this. So, yahan pe substitute ho sakta hai ya yahan pe substitute ho sakta hai. Both are different products. You're getting two of them. Propane also the same thing. N-butane also the same thing. Agar beech mein substitute hua, to it's a different isomer. At corner mein substitute hua, to different isomer. Cyclopentane is symmetrical. So it doesn't matter wherever you substitute BR, it's all the same. That's what the question is asking.
Ma'am, my app is hanging. Can I rejoin the live session?
Yeah, absolutely. Actually, Ishmara, I was planning to end it. It's almost 6, right? So how many questions? We've done like 6 questions so far. I'll just assign this as homework. Do complete this week, okay? So once I see that all of you have done this particular topic on Flipper, then I'll give more questions. All in one guy can share, can do the chapter practice and those other things.
Okay, ma'am.
Take care. All right, we'll end it here. So now you guys have like a taste of like, see, we have studied all the set of reactions, but if you see the questions, it's application on those things. So keep those notes beside you while you're answering the questions. Try to work out the logic. A lot of them will be based on these order of reactivities, the fact that tertiary carbocation is more stable, things like that. So work it out. And then if there's any doubt you have difficulty answering the questions or something like that, we'll do some more work in the next class. But try to do these questions. These are the sort of questions you'll get in the exam. Right.